continues. As always, alongside my partner Al Snow, I am the coach, and Al, we kick things off tonight with the women's champion, but it was so close last week at Judgment Day.
The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by Theodore Long from New Orleans, Louisiana, the women's champion, Jazz.
Now, 1 week ago at Judgment Day, the Fatal 4-Way women's title was on the line. Trish Stratus going for the Stratus faction, takes that nasty fall, and Jazz somehow is able to DDT Jacqueline and come out on top.
There goes Trish back into the ring, seeing the women's championship slip from her fingers yet again.
Trish Stratus has seemingly been behind the eight ball as of late, as Jazz remains the women's champion.
Molly Holly!
Well, 1 week ago, we were live at Judgment Day, and what a night it was! Christian, the new Intercontinental Champion.
And Triple H retains his heavyweight title by the skin of his teeth against Kevin Nash.
Yeah, but that was just the beginning of a hellish week for Triple H. We'll talk all about it, plus some great matches right here on Sunday Night Heat. I am going to need your help here tonight. As you know, my voice is a little bit under the weather, but I know you can help me out with that.
I thought you were going to be
kind of like Peter Brady.
That's one of your favorite shows because, as we all know, you are the old pro, Al Snow. I told you I would get that in.
I know you did, and you did, and thank you. I do appreciate that.
You're very welcome. You're very welcome. Oh, Ivory is always looking fantastic. Tremendous tag team contest as we kick things off here on Sunday Night Heat. Jacqueline teaming up with Ivory to take on Molly and the women's champion, Jazz. But let's talk a little bit real quick, Al, about the fact that Jazz was able to escape last Sunday, still the women's champion, even though Theodore Long said she was behind the eight ball, so to speak.
Well, you know, Coach, if anybody's behind the eight ball, I think it's Theodore Long. Jazz barely got the women's title there at Judgment Day.
Yep.
And then the following night on Monday Night Raw, Theodore Long had the white boy challenge, and Ronnie Mack just barely squeaked by on that by 1 second.
The competition, yeah, competition definitely was stepped up with the white boy challenge. Spike Dudley, no ordinary white boy, as we all know. But I'm beginning to wonder if Theodore Long may have raided Steven Richards' closet here tonight with the pink jacket.
He is styling.
I don't know if you'd call Theodore Long a fashion plate.
Or a clothes horse.
Yes. Well, here we go, Jazz and Jacqueline kicking things off here in this tag team contest. And, you know, we talk about Judgment Day, and we're going to show everybody, you know, exactly what happened this past week on Raw. Let's get right into it with Triple H, the World Heavyweight Champion. Kevin Nash destroyed Triple H at Judgment Day. Then less than 24 hours later, Al had to go one-on-one with the Nature Boy, which we're going to show everybody a little bit later on.
Yeah, Triple H showed up on Monday Night Raw thinking that he would have the night off, but Stone Cold Steve Austin had other plans.
Oh, one, nice big breath by Jacqueline, and Jazz is able to get out.
Drop to a hold.
I think right now, Al, Jazz is getting a little bit ticked up. Oh, nice one.
Back edge. Two.
Oh, and kick out by Jazz.
Keep her off balance.
Did you think, Al, did you think that heading into Raw Monday night, that we would have such an emotional, beautiful move by Jacqueline.
Good lucha hard drive to a drop kick.
And now these women, I'm talking, was there even a tag there? I don't think there was, but Molly is feeling the effects courtesy Ivory.
Hey, this should be a tremendous match because all four of these women were former women's champions.
Doing your homework, Al. I like it.
Thank you.
I like it.
Thank you. I make notes once in a while.
Big shot to the midsection by Jacqueline as now Molly apparently is the legal woman in this matchup.
Jacqueline is tough. Don't underestimate her just because of her height. I've seen that woman actually crack a man's ribs.
You have? Yours?
No, not mine. I never was foolish enough to, you know, confront her.
A shot to the back of Jacqueline by Jazz, and now Molly is in control. Another backbreaker.
I start a fight with a woman, I do it.
Wait a second, here's a cover, ring leg two and a kick out by Jacqueline.
I start a fight with a woman, I do it in public so security can pull her off.
Well, Al, I gotta ask you, obviously, Molly and Jazz are two women.
Oh, to the wall, head scissors.
Are two women that have never gotten along. Here's a tag, and in comes Ivory. How are Molly and Jazz going to get along in this matchup?
Well, they seem to be operating pretty well as a team.
Oh, beautiful cross body by Ivory. Too late, too. On a kick out by Molly.
If Ivory and Jacqueline continue to have the momentum on their side, we'll see if that teamwork fails.
A lot of egos in that matchup right now, and another near pinfall by Ivory, who has a lot of energy, as does all four women here tonight. I think all four brought their A game just 1 week after Judgment Day.
Giant swing. Haven't seen that in a long time. Or you with a woman for that matter.
Well, you don't have to go there.
The elbow,
kind of on a dry spell. We don't need to talk about it, though. Another hook of the leg and another cover by Ivory. But getting back to the emotional night that was on Monday night, it turned out to be more than I think any of us could have ever expected.
Cover again. One.
Oh, my goodness. Ivory trying to end this matchup, Al.
Man.
Seemingly before it ever gets started.
Ivory and Jacqueline have come here to win.
A little bit later on, right here on Heat, the Hurricane goes one-on-one with Christopher Nowitzki right on the top rope. Ivory right to the throat. Jazz falls up with a huge kick. And also, Goldust will be in action a little bit later on as well. Well, also, Al, we're going to take everybody back to Raw. Wait a second. Another cover by Molly. This one just continues at a very, very fast pace.
The momentum has shifted down to Molly and Jazz. Oh, just brutally slamming her down to the mat.
Al, we're also going to take everybody back to Raw and answer the question of who ran over or attempted to run over Goldberg 2 weeks ago on Raw. We found out this past week.
And what a surprise that was.
Oh, wait a second. Here's another cover by Molly, and Jazz is able to kick out.
But it wasn't a surprise as to who put them up to it.
You think so?
Yeah.
I would have to agree with that as well.
I didn't sit there and go, I'm stunned, I'm shocked, I'm aghast, I'm befuddled, I'm amazed that that person was involved.
And we'll reveal that person's identity a little bit later on right here on Heat.
Especially considering the history that those two have.
A lot of history between Goldberg and the Saint. Gotcha, baby. Well, right now, Ivory back to her feet. And now, big shot to the midsection. Ooh. And attempting to get that tag, but can't get over to the corner. And Jacqueline is desperate to get back into this matchup.
Snatched her by the wig.
Say by the wig?
By the wig.
Another cover by... I think that's her real hair.
It is, yeah, but, you know, oh, just slammed her face first into the mat.
Well, Al, I tell you what, it's maybe the first time in Heat history, but these four women, they don't want things to end yet. But, Al, we've got to pay the bills.
Oh, you know it.
So we're going to take a quick break, and folks, we'll be right back. Welcome back to Heat Tag Action. Jazz and Molly taking on Ivory and Jacqueline. And during the break, Al, Jazz has been all over Ivory.
Yeah, Ivory's been wearing Jazz like a new coat.
Here's a cover by Jazz, too, and a near pinfall again.
Ivory needs to make a tag. That's why they call it a tag match. Because she needs to get across that ring and get over into a corner and tag Jacqueline. But Jazz and Molly have been doing a fantastic job of cutting that ring in half and keeping her on their side.
We wondered if they were going to be able to work together, and apparently Theodore Long has prepared his women's champion and Molly very, very well here tonight.
Look, Coach, you may have wondered. I didn't wonder. I know they would work well together. You know why? Because they're both women. And we talked about how they all work together.
Well, they all do have this certain symmetry in the women's world.
They run the world. They have the hive mentality.
Well, speaking of running the world and running our Raw world, what about the fact that Eric Bischoff was nowhere to be seen too much this past Monday night on Raw? A big-time hangover for the co-general manager of Raw.
Could Stone Cold Steve Austin please get Eric Bischoff?
Oh, beautiful move by Jazz, or excuse me, Ivory, and Jazz nearly covered for the pinfall.
Stop the tag. Could he please get him drunk more often and get him sick? On jalapeno peppers.
Combination of the beer and jalapenos and hot dogs and
chicken wings.
We've all been down that road before. And
have we now?
Well, more than we'd like to comment on. But Eric Bischoff, you got to believe that come tomorrow night on Raw, is going to be fully recovered and going to have a lot to say about what Stone Cold Steve Austin did to him last week at Judgment Day and then, of course, on Raw as well.
But I think Stone Cold Steve Austin has handled things terrifically when he was allowed to just do things on his own.
Stone Cold has been a very fan-friendly general manager. Beautiful slam by Jazz. And the women's champion may finish this right now. Ivory kicks out. I would have to agree with you, Al, that Stone Cold has done a fantastic job in his role as general manager. But nobody home. The knees right in the midsection of Jazz. And right now, Al, Ivory desperately
desperately. Well, I think he did a fantastic job last Monday night. He signed a huge match for Bad Blood. He found out who tried to run over Goldberg and who was behind it. Oh, make the tag! Make the tag!
Ivory trying to get to Jacqueline in the corner. You can see him.
You can see the desperation on Ivory's face. She knows she's got to make that tag. Jazz doing everything she can to keep her from making it. Come on.
Only about a foot, foot and a half away on a big shot to the back of the head.
She did it.
Is up, and here comes a very, very fresh Jacqueline.
Oh, and she's hot. Look, she's right across the... Oh, blast her to clear off the ring. Caught the boot.
Oh, man. You mentioned you do not mess with Jacqueline, and right now you are seeing exactly why. Big elbow to the kisser of Jazz, followed up by a big-time drop kick.
Close on her. She'll put your head in your butt when she close on you, I'll tell you that.
Sometimes you absolutely amaze me, I will tell you.
Oh, flapjack.
Beautiful flapjack. And here's a cover by Jack.
One,
will this be
two.
Enough? Two.
Molly coming in for the save. Here comes Ivory. Up, kick fight. Yeah!
I have had visions and dreams like that. Ivory and Molly go out to the floor, leaving Jacqueline and Jazz. And
up on the shoulders. Whoa! I thought she was going to go for a victory roll, but Jazz went into the STF.
The STF is sunk in. A devastating submission maneuver by Jazz.
Ivory comes in for the save. Molly comes in, tosses her out of the ring.
Molly and Ivory are having a match within a match, but right there, Ivory was able to save her tag team partner, Jacqueline.
Oh, boot to the face. Come on, Jack, you get it together. Leapfrogs her.
Little leapfrog, but now Jazz from behind, Allen.
Oh, victory roll.
Beautiful.
One, two.
One, two. That could have been enough.
She got it. See, you never
out of nowhere.
Here are your winners.
Out of nowhere.
Jacqueline and Ivory.
I wonder what Theodore Long's reaction is going to be to this.
Well, Theodore, as we all know, has a very, very short temper. Jubilation on behalf of Ivory and Jacqueline. A hard-fought victory, to say the least. Here tonight. And Theodore Long is furious.
Hey, let me tell you something, player.
Uh-oh.
You saw it and I saw it. Hey, let me tell you something.
We saw it too.
We did see it. A very competitive matchup.
Jacqueline, let me tell you something right now. I see right now what you want to do. You want to play Whitey's game. So you want to go one-on-one?
You want to mess with the baddest?
Well, you can see Jacqueline has no problem with this.
It's on, Jacqueline. It's on, baby girl. You want some of it, we'll give you some. It's on. It's on.
Jacqueline has never backed down from anybody, Al. Well, it's on, but my question is, when is it on?
When?
I'd like to see it right now, if you ask me.
Oh, I would too.
Well, we'll have to wait and see.
Still to come tonight on Heat.